I have some really great news to impart. About 15 years ago, I was shown a very vivid dream that I was aware this is the future, this is what is going to happen. And very detailed, gave me something very detailed, a marker that when this happened, I would know this is the time when you are of your deliverance. You're going to be given sanctuary at this time. And for 15 years, I've been struggling to find out exactly what it is. One thing I do know is during the administration of the 44th president, that is for certain, which we're in right now. But the other part, I couldn't figure out until actually today. And I suddenly realized it's the Snowden affair is exactly the marker I was given. Somebody spilled the beans on all of the data collection and filtering of that data to profile people. Someone spilled the beans. It caused an absolute uproar in intelligence circles. And despite them acting like, wow, it's no big deal, except that is not true. Underneath the surface, it is a huge deal, and they're very furious, which has now been brought to light by the European countries, Portugal, France, Spain, etc., refusing to allow passage of the Bolivian president's airplane and forcing it to land in Vienna, Austria. Obviously, under instructions by the U.S. that they were, it's unprecedented, blocking a presidential airplane like that. So they are absolutely intent on arresting Snowden. And this is what I was shown 15 years ago, and this is the event. And right after this, now, will they arrest him or not? We don't know. My feeling is they will, but we will see. But right after this is playing out, okay, and we will gain asylum. Asylum will be given to those who want asylum in the world. This is a trigger for asylum. This whole event is getting people to think about asylum from this planet, not just from the U.S., from this planet. Okay, because they're seeing, hey, wait a minute, there's a global control structure in place now. So expect sanctuary, asylum from this planet, given to us by what? From another planet. Now, something else that became very clear today as another dream I had, which I was aware it was showing me something cosmically important, but I couldn't figure it out. I really could not until today. And yesterday, scientists have now declared that they were wrong all along, and they're correcting their guesses, as they always do. They now say that they estimate 60 billion habitable planets in the Milky Way galaxy alone. 60 billion habitable planets. Now in John 14 in the Bible, the farewell discourse, Jesus says, don't be troubled. In my Father's house are many rooms, and if it were not so, I would have told you, and I'm going there to prepare one for you, and then I will come back and take you to the place to dwell there with me, and you will know the way, etc. So, obviously, if there are 60 billion inhabitable planets in the Milky Way galaxy alone, I think we can do the math and figure, you know what, there's probably some we're not alone in this galaxy. We're not alone, that is obvious. Now, to tie this all together, it's a big, big, big thing. What I was shown in this dream, I've been struggling with this interpretation. Even earlier today, I got it kind of a little bit wrong, but now it's coming into focus better. Red dwarf. I thought it might be a red giant. A red dwarf, because what I was shown was a small person acting like a red sun, giving me this image of a red sun, but it was a small person, so it wasn't giant. So a red dwarf, and then saying two places there. And what I understand is a lot of these red dwarfs have two habitable planets near them. Also, the planets are in fixed, what do you call it? They're orbitally locked with the red dwarfs, meaning half of the planets are always, you know, oriented towards the sun. They get perpetual sunlight, and that is another very important fact that I've been told, is that there's places of sanctuary where you have perpetual sunlight, perpetual light coming to you 24 hours a day. The other side is perpetually dark there, but you don't live there. You live in this perpetual light there. So I was shown that there are twin red dwarfs or twin planets. I'm not positive about that, which is, you know, which is which, but it's one or the other. Most of the habitable planets are in red dwarf systems, which is a sun that is a lot less light than our sun, and the planets are a lot closer to the sun to be habitable. And they apparently orbit the sun every month or something like that. That the orbit is takes much less time, etc. But there are, again, estimated 60 billion habitable planets in the Milky Way galaxy alone, and who knows, could be a lot more than that. So the idea that we are somehow the only habitable planet in the galaxy is ludicrous, totally ludicrous. So again, if you look at the history of this planet, you know for sure that it has been visited before. There's no question about it. Many times, actually, and many different visitors have come here. There, space travel is a fact, and this planet is well known and has been well visited and interacted with on many levels. So there are habitable planets, there is space travel, etc., etc., etc. So you know, if we decide, hey, this planet here has become very corrupt, as it has, why don't we just call a taxi? You know, like, if we're in a place that's distressed, and let's say we get abandoned somewhere, our car breaks down, whatever, call a taxi. I need to go home, take me home. So we could call a space taxi, and the space taxi can take us to another dwelling place, to either to stay permanently or to temporarily, until this world gets sorted out. Pretty much you have to leave this world to its own resources. Those here who are after the flesh, then they'll have to rely upon their own resources and sort it out and see what happens to that way at orientation of the flesh wants to control the flesh. The Holy Spirit wants to free us from the flesh. The flesh wants to control the flesh, to get the flesh to do exactly what it wants it to do. It wants to control it very much. So you have a world that is based on constant surveillance, constant spying, massive amounts of laws, massive amounts of bureaucracy, massive demands for loyalty oaths, for quota systems, for all this kind of stuff, where political correctness gone absolutely on steroids, all an attempt to the flesh to control the flesh. The flesh wants to make sure that the flesh continues on being loyal to this program. It's a training program of trying to teach spirit how to die. It's trying to teach spiritual death. And so the Holy Spirit says, that's not the answer. I'll give you a training program to help you drop all your definitions of death and drop this whole silly idea of trying to die to what you are, which is impossible. So those oriented in the Holy Spirit's direction most certainly at this point in time must be thinking, you know, like, wow, I could really use sanctuary from this world right now. It's rotten. It's gone very rotten. And the governments of the world are in cahoots with each other. And this whole Snowden affair is pointing out something bigger than just the leaks and whatever. It's pointing out the whole global community is unwilling to do anything. They're intimidated. They're frightened. So we have this now global new world order which is working in cahoots, and so that is the what is much more wow factor to all this. This is what's being pointed out, like, wow, there's no place for us to dwell here. You know, there's no place for freedom in this world anymore. So I believe a lot of people now are going to start saying, hey, what about asylum? Where can I go? You know, like, wait a minute, what if this happened to me? Where could I go? And I've been saying all along, my whole life, relocate to a different planet. And people thought just I was completely nuts. And now it's coming out that 60 billion habitable planets in the Milky Way galaxy alone. 60 billion. Okay. Out of that 60 billion, don't you think that there could be one by a red dwarf that has an atmosphere, that has clouds, water, atmosphere, life, conducive to living, oxygen, all greenhouse gases, etc., etc.? Of course, out of 60 billion. Come on. And there may, who knows how many planets are actually already inhabited. You know, maybe it could be just, you know, incredible number. So we have options. We have options. When a world goes bad, like this one has gone bad, we can say, you know what, let's just transfer to another planet, another world, another dwelling place, or another realm, or another dimension, etc., etc. This is not longer science fiction. It's not science fiction anymore. We have just cause, absolutely just cause at this point, saying, hey, wait a minute, you know, what if I see something that is illegal, against natural law, against, you know, moral law, against all this stuff, what if I say, hey, you know, if this isn't right, then I have no place, you know, to hide in this world at all. No one will give me asylum, etc., etc. So people are thinking, hey, wait a minute, we can't even speak up anymore. We're being intimidated into silence, into a slave planet, into a plantation planet, and we say, hey, let's see if we have options. So in the dream I was shown, we have options. We will escape. We will go elsewhere. We will go elsewhere, and there will be a way to do so. And we will be protected. We will be shielded. We will have refuge. This whole situation in the world is very well known, as a matter of fact, very well known by others, not necessarily from this planet. Others in other dwelling places know what's going on here. The Holy Spirit knows what's going on. There's a great deal of wisdom that's aware of what's going on, and it's. It is what was foretold in scriptures about a very, very bad time when the end of the world cycle will come. We're here, we're at it now, and this Snowden affair is bringing it to light, okay? Bringing it to light. It, you know, the world, it cannot hide anymore from what's going on. It's you know, no country is willing. It's like Jesus at the end, you know, Joseph and Mary say, hey, can we stay here? No, we're all full, I can't stay here. It's Jesus, Joseph and Mary all over again, as it were. And this is just a marker. Not that this person, Snowden, is any, you know, saint or anything like that. It's just that he's an actor on the stage, and this happens to be bringing to light the situation in the world that many of us have known for a long time. This is what's coming, and now it's here. I mean, we know it's here. There's no point anymore in denying it. You know, it's just stupid. It sounds stupid when people start making excuses and justifications and something. You know, it's too late for that. Blaming somebody, oh, well, somebody's fault. You know, no, it's a global system. It's a world educational system. It's a system that's been carefully, meticulously crafted. And put in place. It's the flesh controlling the flesh. Wow, a lot of bugs flying around right now here, all over the place. Yeah. Oh, one just now. Whoa, there's one right there. Okay, that's the same bug that was here before. He's this bug. Hello. Okay. So there's a lot of activity. Some people say that a lot of UFOs, orbs, have been seen lately. A lot, all over the world. They're letting us know, hey, it's coming. It's coming. It is coming. The rapture is coming. The relocation is coming. The exodus is coming. When Egypt got too corrupt, Moses said, hey, time to leave. Time to leave. All right. He got the word. Time to go. And they said, how can we leave? How can we leave? The Red Sea is there. Don't worry. Moses said, there'll be a way. There'll be a way. And so we're at that time now where it's time for exodus. It's time for exodus. When minds, you know, little games takes place, it's running one of its games, and it's time to, you know, opt out of that game, which we will do. What is important and what I want to convey is finally I have been able to put two and two together and understand those key dreams I was given so long ago that warned me, prepared me, said you better get prepared for the times that are coming, and finally put two and two together and see we're at it right now. This drama that's playing out right now is the time. And we could see it happen in the second half of 2013. As I've been saying, the second half of 2013 is where it's at, is really where it's at. And we're going to see miracles in the second half of 2013. We're already seeing Egypt again falling apart just like kaboom, up within a matter of a couple days, you know. And so it's on, it's absolutely on right now. So lift your heads up at this time and say, you know what? We are going to get help. We are going to get help. We are not going to be dragged down into the abyss. We are not going to be put into re-education camps. We're not going to go along with the mind's games, the mind games of the mind. We have seen through the whole thing. We know we have options, and we know, and so we're exercising options. What we can do is we can formally request asylum. Okay, we can formally request asylum. We can say, you know what, planet, I don't need your name, planet, but I know that there is an offer of asylum out there, and I'm applying to all the planets that are willing to offer me asylum. Let me get the very best situation for what I'm all about. And we're asking for formally requesting asylum right this very moment. So we can do that. We can absolutely do that. I did that today, right? And also requested asylum from various spiritual teachers who will know where it's best for us to go, etc., etc. They're very aware. The high spiritual teachers are very aware of other dwelling places. They're not stupid. And we're the ones that are stupid on this planet thinking this is it. That's really stupid. It's very unaware. But the great teachers, sages, saviors, gurus, etc., they know very well that there's many rooms in the galaxy, in the universe, etc., etc., many dwelling places. And they're aware of the little petty tyranny drama that's taking place on this planet, and mind's games, etc., etc. They're aware of all this stuff. So we can formally request a refuge, asylum, from the great teachers and gurus and from the planets, etc. Just like Snowden is formally requesting asylum in these countries, we can formally request asylum from other dwelling places. There's no, what's to stop us? Why not, you know? Why not do that? What do we have to lose? What do we have to lose? Wouldn't it be great to have that option in our back pocket? And saying, well, my request for asylum has been granted. You know, my request for asylum has been granted. So that's what I'm waiting for. I put my request out, and I'm waiting for it to say your request has been granted, and you will be given safe passage to this to another dwelling place. There to continue to pursue the Holy Spirit's training program to prepare for that and to get into the Holy Spirit's program and begin it and begin the training program. So at the very least, we should have this request for asylum granted to us and have the safe passage, quote-unquote, papers in our back pocket. We should have that at this time. I mean, that just makes sense. There's no place in this world, really, where we can, where we're really safe. What's that? So it makes sense to request asylum from another dwelling place. It's just common sense that we now know for sure there must be many such places. And spirit, thought, intent travels faster than light. Okay? It's instant. So you another planet can receive your request instantaneously. Okay? So they know you've made the request and they can respond, boom, like that. All right? And we've been told that indeed at this end times that Jesus would come back with a lot of transport angels, etc., to, you know, take those who want to leave this planet, take them to a better dwelling place for sure. So it's out of the realm of foggy thoughts and musings. It's into the realm of very crystal clear clarity right now, based, you know, on the times that we live in. We're up to speed on everything right now. And we say, yeah, we're up to speed. We get it. And now we see, hey, we can make this request for asylum. Why not? What do we have to lose, really? People sneering at us, etc. Well, it's stupid not to make such requests. If there are other planets, and now we have to assume that there are many, 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 many habitable planets, and most likely, you know, that they're inhabited, it would be stupid not to make those requests. To at least have options in case this world gets really, really, really bad. And I see it as getting, it's already really, really bad in my opinion. It's already a lost cause. It's already a black sheep. And so, but just in case it gets intolerable for you, why not have that in your back pocket? And you can say, you know what, I want to exercise this asylum, safe passage I have that's been granted to me. I want to exercise it at this point. You can exercise it whenever you want. If you have letters of passage, you can exercise those whenever you want. But at least get the letters of passage in your pocket. So, you know, meet with the representatives, the gurus, or whatever, whoever is the representatives of those ambassadors. Meet with them and be willing to meet with them. The high ambassadors can materialize like that. They can materialize anywhere. Meet with them. And say, you know, and say, I made a request for asylum. Will you grant it to me? And they say, yes, it's been granted to you, etc. Why not? This is the time we live in now. You know, the time for all the silliness is past. You know, when hardcore scientists are saying 60 billion habitable planets in the Milky Way galaxy, you know they're getting us ready for something. You know it. You absolutely know it. It's the same way when the Catholic Church says, folks, if it will be announced tomorrow that they're extraterrestrials, etc., we want to tell you for sure it should not cause any problem with your faith. The faith will be exactly the same. That literally has been said recently in the homilies of Catholic Church. So they know there's ETs, and they're just getting people ready for disclosure, saying, you know, don't freak out. Don't freak out. That's what they're saying. So here we are. So all this stuff is known. We know that the Earth has been visited by ETs throughout history. We know they're habitable planets. The next logical step is asylum, is requesting asylum. Ooh, the bug just came through. And, there's another one. Bugs are all over the place, aren't you? Interesting. This is a different one. Whoa! They're buzzing me. The bugs are buzzing. Wow. Yeah, we may get buzzed. The world may be, there may be a false flag that is going to try and scare us. You know, Project Blue Beam, false flag, all this stuff. There could be vessels that are black op vessels that are will be shown to the world that are like hostile, give a hostile presence to try and make us think that ETs or, you know, other worlds or planets are hostile to us, and therefore asking asylum is a crazy dangerous thing to do. So that may happen. That is possible. That could happen. That's don't discount that is something that could happen. So we'd say, oh, ETs, they're all terrible. They're all bad. All habitable planets must be dangerous to us. They want to enslave us. Oh, they're terrible, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So we remain here as slaves on this plantation. It's like the plantation owner's trying to scare the slaves, saying, you can't leave this plantation. Other plantations are much, much worse. You got to stay right here. It's that kind of thing. It's exactly that kind of thing. So that's possible. That's very possible. Whoa! Just got buzzed again. Holy smokes. How many times have my face gotten hit and boom, 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 like that? I don't know what it means. But it's not hurting me. It's not hurting me. Maybe it, I don't know, maybe it's a positive thing. We'll see. So this is now, again, all this stuff is on the table now. It's absolutely on the table. And you just have to realize the times we live in. I know many people do, especially the younger people are much more hip to this stuff than the older people. The older people, you know, are just kind of, I don't know. The younger people know that there are ETs, know that they're habitable planets. They know all this stuff. And it's just they have to put the dots. They haven't quite connected the dots. Request asylum from another planet. How difficult is that to understand? How difficult is that to understand? Don't waste your time requesting asylum on this planet. From, you know, if you get asylum somewhere in South America, they'll send the drones after you. So forget it. Forget it on this planet. I've said all along, forget this planet. That is not in play. Request asylum from another planet, another dwelling place for sure. And see what happens. So let's do it. We humbly, gratefully request asylum on another planet. And we like our request to be expedited as fast as possible. And we like our safe letters of passage be given to us as soon as possible. Thank you very much. And let's see what happens next. Stay tuned.